live from Los Angeles. Welcome back to Good Morning LaLa Land. I am so excited because we have BJ the Dreamer in the house, number one Amazon best-selling author, producer of Carpool Karaoke. Man, you are living the dream.
Yes. And that is the title of my book, Live Your Dreams Out Loud. And I mean, I am actually living it. It's a blessing.
Wow.
Good for you.
Yeah.
Did you have mentors? How did you get in this mindset?
Well, I'll start here. My story, I'll try to wrap it up for you as quick as possible. I'm from a small town in Alabama called Skipperville, population of about 600 people. And so this notion of dreaming has always been instilled into me. But being in Skipperville, you don't see anything other than armadillos, you know, one caution light. There's not much to see. And so I've just always been this curious person. And so prior to moving to Los Angeles, I found a mentor, somebody who was already doing something that I wanted to do. And what I wanted to do was come out here and host my own show. I wanted to write books. I wanted to speak. I wanted to change people's lives just through my story and just my passion and just that time wave of I knew it was the right time to do it. So I got that mentor. He brought me out here to Los Angeles. And, you know, 2 years within, I got a chance to work on the Arsenio Hall show. Bill Nye's show for Netflix, James Corden's Carpool Karaoke, the spinoff series for Apple. And so now I host a web series. I wrote a book and it's a bestseller. And, you know, I'm working on these shows. It's truly living the dream and I'm truly blessed. Yeah.
But how did you do it? Because so many people move to Los Angeles with a dream.
Right.
And they all die trying. How did you really make yours a reality?
I found somebody that was doing something that I was already looking to do. And learn from them, but more importantly, I added value to them. I didn't ask for anything in return because what I was getting from them was bigger than what they could, any paycheck. I didn't get no paycheck whatsoever, but I just found somebody who was already doing something very similar to me, and I added value to them and just worked alongside them.
Mm.
Yeah.
Such an important distinction.
Yeah.
I think that we're all students and teachers always. And so who are your students? Who are those people?
I mean, I have a lot of people across, I call them dreamers, a lot of dreamers across the world who I mentor, who are part of my online courses. I teach people how to write their book. I also have people teach people how to go about living their dreams and what is their dream process. And I tell everybody, listen, we all got different dreams. And I'm not saying that my way is the best way, but what I did go through and the steps that I did take to get there, it's a part of my book. I have a six-step strategy. And that six-step strategy came about from me surveying over 3,000 people, doing an ask campaign online. And asking them, what is the number one thing, you know, that you have to do in order to give up? I mean, if you were wanting to achieve your dreams, what is the number one thing that you're missing? And so through that ask campaign, I just got great responses, and that became the framework to my book.
Wow, what kinds of things did you hear in response when you asked that question?
People not necessarily thinking they have the right amount of time to do it, thinking they're too old, they're not clear about their dreams, they don't necessarily have the cash flow. They don't have the connections. They don't feel as if they're competent to go about pursuing their dreams. So those are the things that pretty much became the framework.
I find it so interesting that people think that they have to be in a certain place, mindset, financial status in their life to start actually living their dreams.
Right. You can do it right now.
Mm-hmm.
And that's an excuse. You know, excuses are tools of the incompetent that build bridges that lead to nowhere.
Oh, say that again!
Yeah. Excuses are tools of the incompetent that build bridges that lead to nowhere.
I love it.
Oh,
yeah. But we know the number one thing is definitely belief when it comes to overcoming all those things. Because knowing it's possible, you can have that gap and find those answers, find that people, find that information that you need. How do you believe that people get to that belief? Is it through deep, deep personal work, or is it And is it to find somebody that they know has done it?
I don't think it's really black and white. I really feel as if it's just a situational basis. Sometimes we as individuals have to go through something, or I say we have to grow through something to get us there. That belief, I mean, maybe you have to find somebody else that's already doing it. You know, I tell people all the time, in order to get that belief, find somebody that's a direct mentor and get somebody that's an indirect mentor. A direct mentor meaning somebody that you may actually pay to be your mentor or your life coach. An indirect mentor can be somebody like a Tony Robbins or an Oprah or Brendan Burchard or somebody like that, and learn from them. And sometimes that reignites or ignites that belief in you that you need in order to pursue.
You're reigniting that belief in me right now.
Yeah.
Really, you are. Your work is so inspirational. We know that you're going to be speaking at the Positivity Summit as well. Tell us a little bit about that.
Man, I'm excited. Cornell and I met through mutual friends, through one of our mutual friends who works for the Portland Trail Blazers. So we just met online and just talking about just sharing good energy. He was like, listen, I know you through this guy. I want to come to LA. I want to do this event. You know, let's just link up and talk. And we just started linking up and talking through online. And here we are now. This was maybe 9 months ago. And so here we are getting ready to have this positivity summit. Yourself is going to be there as one of the speakers. So I'm excited about it.
And what's your talk on?
Living your dreams.
Oh, there it is.
Yeah, living your dreams. Living your dreams, the whole process. I want to give people the process of something that they can take away that's tangible for them to go out and live their dreams.
I love it. Yeah. And tell us when it is.
October 20th. It'll be downtown at General Assembly, October 20th. I'm not sure the actual speaking lineup yet, but yeah, we're going to be there.
All going to be fantastic.
You got to be there. Yeah. I mean, because I don't want to go after you.
We go together because I don't want to go after
we're,
you.
We're holding hands and saying kumbaya.
Exactly, there it is.
And in the meantime, where can people find you and your book?
I'm online at BJ the Dreamer. My book's online and at Amazon.com. We have the new 5-year anniversary coming up. So the book, the updated and revised version will be coming out in a few months. So I'm really excited about that. But all social media is at BJ the Dreamer.
Ah, congratulations. Yeah.
Check them out.
So thank you all so much. Yep. And listen, thank you so much for having me. I'm a fan of this show. I watch you all. Congratulations to everything. Listen, I am so proud of you all, and I'm just glad to see the things that you all are doing.
Love you, man.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
We're living the dream. Stay tuned. We'll be back with more on Good Morning LaLa Land.